I will present Internet of Things in the monitoring physical parameters. The introduction Internet of Things in monitoring physical parameters are the monitoring factors, data request, analyze, storage, and data transmissions. The material and method, a basic component of the system. It's the Arduino Nano, Arduino Mega, EEG module, pulse and sensor, ECP Wi-Fi module, accelerometer, SD card, and the buzzer LED alert, and the display for the information device. The diagram block is to the system a slave data transmitter and the master data receiver is the function. Materials method, the acquisition part of the data from the sensor was resided to the microcontroller at Megatrade.io at Mega. The material method with the SP module Wi-Fi. This module has been the role of transmission data from the patient of the recording system in the cloud. I having in the fixed IP travel with the pairing between master module and the slave module will be performed. In order to be able to acquisition the processing of the biological signal EEG, we use an instrumentation amplification together with the analog to digital converter. First channel is for the displaying the electrocardiogram, with the second is for the determining the respiratory function. It is designed to extract and amplify low value biosignal. The pulse sensor has been used to the collect data about heart beat under normal condition as well. Physical effort. Recording data, we will use the separately monitoring the patient, both health and unhealth. It is very useful to record the medical data on the SD card memory. Accelerometer is used, can detect the patient movement relative to three axes. The mobility of the three axis is determining according to the position it will take at the time of the calibration. For the patient wearing both visual, acoustic elements were can choose. Piezoelectric buzzer was used. On the visual side, a red LED was used the light up to the goals on the different mode alert visual. Display OLED is very used together with the Arduino Uno development board. The capture information display with the 0.96 inch diagonal display. The power supply, the system of the device was powered by voltage change module consumption of the lithium-ion battery with capacity for the complete system as an automatic 8 and 10 hours, the functionality. And the result and discussion, the source code of the system in attending to the functional reality, to the acquisition and the processing of a biomedical signal contained. First step of the structure, the code was check each module if it is connected correctly. I will present in figure 10 source code system. And the conclusion, preliminary result has been showed that the device is capable to of the talking in the signal from a attached module. Development of the such system represent a wide field to of research that involved both knowledge. in the biomedical field and the engine field. Optimize of the devices necessary to achieve accreditation of the real-time data, but also patient safety. Thank you for your attention. Ask you.
Okay, thank you for your presentation. Questions from the audience, please. Okay.
So it seems I'm the most active participants in
yes,
terms
yes.
of us asking questions. Well, first of all, I would like to thank Robert for this nice presentation. And as a clinician, I know what is the price of getting data on time. And he explained us one of the ways it can be done. My question is about the use of this data. Have you tried to elaborate on this? The same old question. Machine learning used for this, and especially in a clinical setting.
The machine learning in the first step, and with the another step, the clinical information for the data acquisition.
I see. Then can you tell me which are the main machine learning models for analyzing and pre-processing the data are you using?
The processing in the software processing with the Arduino software developer. In the show the electrocardiogram graphics.
I see. How about machine learning algorithm? There are a variety of them, and many of them simply cannot be applied to this time series data. It's quite a problem working with this type of data, and not all the machine learning is appropriate or good for this.
Okay.
This. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Machine learning, it's a second step. Now it's about MATLAB and LabVIEW acquisition and processing.
Yes, I agree with you, but this time I'm asking as a practicing physician that would like to get information to be used directly in the decision making process. And this is why I'm torturing the presenters with my maybe not very appropriate questions. But once again, I'm a physician and I would like to find out what can I use from this directly in my practical activity. Sorry.
We understand.
For...
No, it's no problem. It's a good idea. And it's this is the future. Machine learning is the future in medical decision. I am a biomedical engineer, and I work with a physician. And every day, they ask me how to resolve this problem or this problem in appropriate time.
Yes, we will jump higher or not.
Yes, correctly.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.